everyone, welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Card Openings, and welcome to our first episode of 2024. I'm Celeste, I'm your host, and this is Sidekick Suicune. Today we're going to go over all of the incredible Pokemon related stuff that I got for my birthday and for Christmas, and then we're going to open up some cards. So let's go ahead and show off what I got. Okay, so for my birthday I got this really fun Quackquable. I actually don't know how you say this guy's name, but I got this tin, which of course, you know, has the promo card, and it's gonna have 5 booster packs in it. So that's what I want to open up for today, I think. But I got that. I also got this really cool Snorlax Pokemon Go tin, which has quite a few packs in it as well. The 24, oh my goodness, it has 4 booster packs in there. I got a pack of the Trick or Trade booster bundles from this year's Halloween event, which is really fun. I'm not sure exactly when we're gonna open those, but we will get to those. I got not one, but 2 Pokeball tins, which, you know, I like to go to places and show off kind of the local area. So since I'm in DC, I think one of these will definitely be a monument tour. And I think maybe we could go to Mount Vernon for the other one. So we'll just kind of see when that plays out. And I also got a couple singles. So we have a really good mix here of cards that I got for my birthday from my parents. And then of course for Christmas, I got this really cute Pikachu who is winking from my grandma and papa. And they also got me a couple more singles, so I'm definitely looking forward to opening that up and doing a video for them because they are huge supporters of the channel. Thank you, Grandma and Papa, so much. I will definitely do a special video just for you opening these up. But for today, like I said, I think we're going to go ahead and just open up this tin, so we'll get everything else cleared away really quick so we have lots of space to see what is inside this little tin. All right, so I just went ahead and started opening this plastic, and I did get a tiny little paper cut, which I'm sure you noticed. I didn't realize it was bleeding, so I just put a little Band-Aid on it really quick, but I am fine. I think I cut myself on the cardboard edge when I was trying to get pictures for the thumbnail, which happened, so no, it's not a big deal. I'm fine. But that's why I have a Band-Aid. So, but look at the star pattern here in this hollow. That is so pretty. It is very reminiscent of like the early cards. And I want all of my cards to look like this. There's just so many stars. So we'll just put our little promo there. This is for you guys. Thank you so much for supporting and watching the channel. I hope that is a really good code card for you and you get lots of good stuff. If you are playing online, let me know. And if you want more code cards, I am always willing to share, but let me know what you get because I do am very interested. And then here are the packs that come in here. We have a very good selection, 2 Obsidian Flames, Scarlet and Violet, Silver Tempest, and Astral Radiance. So this is definitely a newer tin, obviously. So let's start with, I don't know, I like all this pack art so much. I'm gonna go with Scarlet and Violet since that is the base for that, and then we have Sword and Shield ones. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that first. Then we'll do all of our Scarlet and Violet cards first, and then we can open up the Sword and Shield, or maybe we'll do every other one, kind of mix it up. Let's see. I know that these are the new cards because they have the silver border around them rather than the old gold border, and there is at least one shiny card in here. So it looks like the back card is going to be our energy card. So the card trick for these is one from the back to the front, and we know it is a grass energy. So let's go ahead and sit through these really quick. Like I said, I got these for my birthday. I just turned 32. It was a really, really great time. My mom and dad and my brother all came up from Alabama to visit me here in my new apartment in Virginia. and I really enjoyed having them here. It was such a good time. We did some fun stuff. We are going to, whoa, look at that guy. I don't even know what this is. Oh my gosh, and there's more. Okay, this is a regular rare holographic, and then this is, sorry, I'm just so distracted with how shiny this is. This is really cool. So it evolves from Bisharp into a Kingabit. Kingabit? I don't know. It's really cool though. It's got a gold star, so that's definitely a fun card to have. We'll put all of our shiny cards up here. Got our promo, our other cards. I'm guessing the reverse and holographic. The new sets have me a little bit confused because I haven't opened up enough of them or watched enough people open them up to know what all of the new symbols mean, and all the like the gold star, like if that's, that means ultra rare probably, but like I'm not sure where exactly on the scale of rareness it is, you know, because I think I've seen some with like a couple stars, which there used to be old cards like that. Like I have a shining Magikarp that has three black stars in the corner. I have that. Let me go grab it. Okay, so I had to dig this out. I'm still in boxes getting my all my stuff unpacked and my new office set up. This is my vintage binder. If you want to see what's in it, there are other videos. I was mistaken. The Shining Magikarp only has one star, but I know there's something that has three stars. That's an old card. I don't remember what it is though. I really thought it was the Shining Magikarp. Let me think about that for a second. Here it is. It is the Shining Celebi. I knew it was a Shining card. But as you can see, the old school version of like Ultra Rare, we had three black stars here. But they didn't do that a lot, just in a few cards, and it happens to be on the Shining Celebi. So there you have it. Like I said, that is my vintage collection. I will make sure to leave a link to my entire vintage old binder collection. It has all of the original like basic cards from when I first started collecting, and across a couple of binders you can see everything I have. I think this is Sword and Shield, so it should be, yes, four to the front. That's the other thing, is now that we're getting all the a mix of stuff, I gotta keep track of what era we're in and what the card trick is. Quilava is, and this whole the Cyndaquil Quilava Typhlosion is one of my favorite evolutions, honestly. I am so glad to have that. So this guy evolves into that. We'll see if we can get the whole thing here. Psyduck, there's Psyduck for Real Breaking Nate. Hope you're having a great new year, Nate. Togepi, and oh my goodness, what were we even talking about? Just the ultra rares, I think. And like there's a Cyndaquil. Oh, and a Leafeon! So cute. We love that. Okay, so this is like this pile. This is like our rare pile. Though I guess that's not holographic, so it shouldn't technically be out there, but it's a Leafeon, and we love our evolutions here, so we're gonna leave it up there. Let's switch back into some Scarlet and Violet. For now, we're gonna open up the Dragonite pack art, I think. But yeah, like I said, I got this for all my birthday stuff. It was so much fun. I got to go see The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes, which is the newest installment in the Hunger Games movies. Look, so we have another one, but I guess technically that guy goes with this. This will be in the same set, so that's... Oh, a Wiglet. It's really, really good. If you haven't seen it or read the book, I definitely recommend if you like the Hunger Games. It was super good. Okay. All right. So these ones must just have a lot of shiny in them. I don't know. But I'm not here to argue with it. So like we got two commons and one rare. So, like I said, I'm getting used to these new sets. They're a little bit different. I love this Lugia though. So cool. I have always loved Lugia ever since the movie. Would that be Pokemon 2000, I think? That has been a while ago. Wait, when this is an old one. I knew that was gonna happen as soon as I switched back and forth. With Lugia and the Legendary Birds. It was just such a fun movie. Very nostalgic. I'm gonna have to go look that up somewhere and see if I can find it. I've been wanting to rewatch the movies for a while. I watched Detective Pikachu for the first time a while ago and I really enjoyed that. Ooh, is there an aura? Very cool. I really thought that that was a cute movie. And I think it would be a really fun to have more movies, so I hope that they kind of keep on doing that. Give us some more stuff to watch in the future. Is that Pokemon 2000? I don't know. No, because the Celebi one is Pokemon Forever, so it has to be Pokemon 2000. All right, I'm going to give you one last code card for watching. Thank you so much for joining us today. I am so excited to have you here. This is a new set, so it's just one. Okay, awesome. Awesome, awesome. If you are new to the channel, thank you for joining us today. If you would like to subscribe to the channel, I would love that. I definitely, my next goal is to get 200 people, so we just need about 50 more people to get there, and we'll have a little celebration. And then we can just keep growing and growing, but your support means a lot to me. So we have a Surskit, we have a Poniard. Oh look, we have all three of them. So our last card. Oh my gosh, it's an Entei! No way, dude, look at that! What a way to end! Oh my gosh, I love the legendary dogs so much, which obviously, you know, Suicune is my favorite, but this Entei is out of this world, man. So cool. Absolutely a banger. All right, huge thank you to Mom and Dad for the birthday presents of Pokemon cards. I never dreamed as a kid that I would still be in this hobby as an adult, and honestly, it has just been so much fun. To anyone who is thinking that you want to give up on a hobby or whatever, don't. It's way too much fun, and life is too short to not have some fun. So thank you, Mom and Dad, for supporting the channel, supporting me, for being amazing, for making my birthday really special. I love you so much. And thank you everyone else who is watching and who is liking and commenting and subscribing. It also means a lot for me that you guys are here on my journey and just enjoying the Pokemon cards with me. So I hope you guys have a fantastic new year. We're going to be doing a lot of cool stuff. I think it's cool. A lot of new things on the channel here coming up. If you're interested, make sure you're subscribed. Stick around and see what new things are on the way. Till then, have a great rest of the day and happy new year. See you next time. Bye.